This Ness City High School FFA broadcast is brought to you by American Family Insurance agent Mary Jo Hayflicker, BTI, J&D Pump and Supply, South Fork Meat Processing, G&L Health Mart, DE Bondurant Grain Company, and by Swift Services.
Hello, everybody. Jeremy McGuire. We are in Ness City at Ness City High School National FFA Week, February 17th through the 24th. I can, we will is the theme this year, and we're going to introduce you to some FFAers here in Ness City and talk about some of the activities and events they have going on this week. So who do we have here?
Jocelyn Walker.
All right, Jocelyn, talk about what you have going on this week.
So this week we're having a fundraiser where we put a bucket in each teacher's classroom, and then whoever gets the most money gets to kiss an animal on Ag Awareness Day. And last year we had Coach Coles, and he kissed a donkey. And then after, we take the money to a local shelter. Last year it was Golden Belt Humane Society in Great Bend, and this year we'll take it to Hayes.
How fun is that to see one of your teachers have to kiss an animal?
It's pretty exciting. Everyone gets really excited about it, and it's all over Snapchat and social media. And
does anybody load any of the teachers' buckets up on purpose?
Oh, yeah. Last year, I remember I brought a lot of change to put in.
Who are you hoping for this year?
I think we should try to get Mrs. Stoss to kiss an animal, because that would be pretty fun, but
well, she wasn't even paying any attention, so she's not sure. So, but, hey, it should be a fun week, and good luck, and enjoy it, okay?
All right, thank you.
You're welcome. All right, and who do we have here?
Braden Vogel.
And, Braden, you're talking about hiding an emblem or something along those lines.
We're going to be hiding an emblem to try to get the kids active in the school where they can find it and get a cool prize.
All right, so who's doing all the hiding?
I believe Miss Stoss is.
All right, is she going to let you guys know anything about where it's at, or are you guys left out of the loop?
I'm hoping I can get a couple hints. A
couple hints and maybe sell them off to some of your classmates?
Probably.
What do you like best about National FFA Week?
It just gives people knowledge about, like, what FFA is. Like, most city kids wouldn't know, but since we're being a rural community, they might know a little bit more.
All right, got to ask you, are you a John Deere guy or something else?
Case.
Case. We got a Case IH guy here. All right. Don't say that too loud around these parts, all right?
For sure.
Hey, enjoy National FFA Week.
Thank you.
You're welcome. All right, and who do we have here?
Kinsey Cup.
And Kinsey, talk about what you have going on for National FFA Week.
Well, at the beginning of our week, what we do is we have a ceremony for the school, and we have, like, a special Pledge of Allegiance, and then we'll give the students donuts. And then for the themes, we have red, white, and blue on Tuesday, because Monday we don't have school. And then Wednesday we have Western Wear, Thursday we have Animal Day, and then Friday we have FFA Pride.
What do you like best about National FFA Week?
Well, it's just an exciting time for FFA, and it's just to tell, like, all of our whole school how exciting FFA can be.
All right. Well, good luck and have fun, okay?
I sure will.
All right. And who do we have here?
Carrie Brunts.
And Carrie, talk about what you have going on.
So I'm kind of helping with the Ag Awareness Day, and basically what that is, we invite the elementary students at Ness City and the Sacred Heart School in Ness, and we're actually going to invite the Western Plains students over this year, so we'll have all those students, and usually it's around 200, and we have, like, a BTI station, and Maddie and Brittany Nikapor are going to talk about, like, byproducts and beef and stuff like that, and then we'll have just students will bring their animals, and we set it up out in there, and we'll have the tower garden, so we'll go over aeroponics and aquaponics, and we'll have chicks and rabbits and just.
Do you know what animal you're bringing yet?
I'm probably going to bring my heifer.
All right. Is she well behaved?
For the most part.
Well, might watch out for the heifer, but do you enjoy National FFA Week?
Yeah, it's really fun being able to just advocate ag and really teach the younger students what ag is really about, and hopefully encourage them to join FFA when they get in high school and junior high.
All right, great job. Thank you, and have fun this week.
Thank you.
You're welcome. All right. And who do we have here?
Taylor Murray.
All right, Taylor. Give us the scoop this week.
All right. Well, for one of our big fundraisers for FFA Week is we have our annual community breakfast. And it takes place on the last Saturday of FFA Week, which this year it would be the 24th of February. We host it every year here in our ag classroom. A lot of our FFA members and students as well get up really early in the morning to come here and cook breakfast for you guys. Our community members are always more than welcome, along with other faculty and staff in the school as well. We cook normally pancakes, sausage, eggs, bacon, the whole nine yards. And the nice thing about it is it's not only a great fundraiser, but it's a great way to bring involvement into our community as well.
Do you enjoy cooking for that?
I actually really do, yes.
All right, and you guys, not only are you getting up early, you're getting up early on a Saturday.
I know. It takes a lot of time and effort, along with not only our fundraisers, but other things that we do in our chapter as well. It takes a lot of time and effort, but I think that shows a lot about us as a chapter for putting that time and effort into those little things.
All right, well, good luck with the whole week and good luck with the breakfast.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. All right, and who do we have here?
Clay Beitler.
And Clay, talk about what you have going on this week.
Basically, why we do all this stuff is to help raise money for our chapters so we can go on trips, and it can help scholarships for our seniors. And
are you looking forward to the week?
Yeah, it's kind of fun to be able to be around my friends, and we got a great ag advisor, and it's a good time.
She didn't even pay you to say that, did she?
Nope, not at all.
what's your favorite part? Is it the breakfast? Is it the FFA Pride Day where you guys have all the kids and you're kind of showing them the ropes? What do you think is your favorite?
It's probably being around the kids, being able to educate them, because you know they could be coming back here someday, and it's a really ag-based community around here.
All right, well, enjoy National FFA Week and have a great week. Okay.
All righty, thank you. Will do.
Thank you. National FFA Week, again, February 17th through the 24th. I Can, We Will is the theme this year. A lot of things going on here at Ness City High School. They talked about the Red, White, and Blue Day on Tuesday. There's Western Wear on Wednesday. Thursday is a Dress Like an Animal Day. FFA Pride Day on Friday. And then the Community Breakfast here at the high school. That will be on Saturday the 24th. So for a great group of FFA kids and a great advisor as well, this is Jeremy McGuire saying so long from Ness City High School.
This Ness City High School FFA broadcast is brought to you by American Family Insurance agent Mary Jo Hayflicker, BTI, J&D Pump and Supply, South Fork Meat Processing, G&L Health Mart, DE Bondurant Grain Company, and by Swift Services.